Let's bring in former House Intelligence Chairman Mike Rogers and former federal prosecutor and current defense attorney Shan Wu. Mike, give us the significance of this because again, we're getting kind of smoke signals from the special counsel's investigation here. But those smoke signals keep pointing to conversations between the president's campaign chairman and a Russian known to be working for Russian military intelligence and communications that Manafort repeatedly lied about. Significance.
Yeah. Well, it's very significant. It's a couple of reasons. One, this happened well into 2018. So this is well down the track of both the president being elected and seated and going through the process of his administration, number one. But number two, this to me shows, as an old FBI guy, that the same kind of attitude that got him in trouble in the first place got him in trouble the second round. He thought he was going to outsmart the prosecutor. He thought he was going to outsmart the folks because he had this guy from overseas who's probably had some training, at least some limited training in intelligence if he had a relationship, as they'd state, with the intelligence services of Russia. He was running his office in Ukraine. I mean, all of that smells bad to me, and it means that there's probably a whole, under that redaction is some really interesting reading that we're not going to get to see, at least right away.
To that point, though, you see it a little bit differently, Shan, just in that you believe that some of Manafort's defenses here are plausible.
Yeah, I think in Manafort's defense and his legal team's defense, it's a lot of detail, it's a lot of debriefings, and it's possible to make some mistakes. However, I would agree with Mike, the overall picture looks bad. I mean, when I bring in someone to cooperate,
right,
we are meticulous in going through the material. And most importantly, you have to have a degree of rapport and trust with the prosecution. If there's any questions, you can tell what areas your client's going to be unclear on.
Right.
That's got to be flagged. So this whole picture looks very bad.
Can I just ask you as a follow-up, because you were, I should note this just for transparency, you did represent Rick Gates previously. And we did learn also yesterday, Rick Gates is still cooperating, and Manafort said, Mueller's team said at least two more months of that. Significance?
Right. I think that is very significant. I'm not commenting on anything confidential or privileged, but the fact that Gates has been silent and now this information has surfaced, he's still cooperating on a number of investigations, that means a lot. It may also signal that we're not as close to the end as we are speculating with regard to
that. Yes, there's been a lot of that, like bring the troops home for Christmas, right? It always gets pushed out.
Right.
Mike Rogers, for folks at home who are not following the intricacies of every development, give us kind of a big picture update as to what we know, what's been revealed from this black box of the Mueller investigation on that essential question. Is there evidence that you've seen as a former Republican member of Congress that at least it's still an open question as to whether there was cooperation between the Trump campaign and Russia?
Well, it's not clear to me, even after seeing all of this evidence, that it wasn't an individual who had contracts in Russia. You have to remember, this is what made him a millionaire,
Manafort.
In the Ukraine, in Manafort. This is what got him rich over the years. He was really out of the political consulting business domestically for 10 years or something. And so this is the kind of thing, and he just sold his soul to the devil, clearly, when you read the material that you see before you, that he decided he didn't care that he was going to work for a pro-Kremlin candidate in Ukraine and everything that was that entailed. And by the way, it's really difficult to walk down the street and not bump into somebody that works for Russian intelligence in Kiev, right? And so he would know that. And the way that they structured the money, so this is a guy that clearly had his vested interest in his future in these gray area, if not corrupt area, of dealing politically over there. So what I saw here is when he went to Spain, which was the big revelation of late, to meet with Kalimnik and gave him...
After the election
and gave him polling information, actually, during the election,
the
he went and gave him polling information. Was he doing that for his own self-interest, or was he doing that at behest of the campaign? That's what I haven't seen yet, and I wouldn't make the jump that the campaign said, go do this quite yet. I just haven't seen that much.
And we wouldn't know that had the redactions on that been a little bit better or as foolproof as the redactions
I have a feeling Mr. Wu's client is probably going to be found in some of those redactions.
No comment on that.
Because we know that Manafort's lawyers have accidentally revealed through these non-redacted, what should have been redactions, that he did share the polling data with Kalimnik. But now we know, Shan, that the two men were communicating while Manafort was still working for the campaign. So does connecting those dots take you any further in your belief?
It does. I mean, I think factually, yes, you don't have that last bit of nexus. Did somebody in the campaign, did the president okay those contacts? But I think the problem at this point is the campaign was in touch with the Russian intelligence people because Manafort was the campaign chair. I mean, that's sort of like a closed book at this point. So that has been established. The only question is how deep, how much knowledge, who had the knowledge now. So I think that bridge has really been crossed at this point.
And also to be clear, that wasn't the only line of communication between Trump world, Trump campaign, and Russians. Yeah. I mean, both before and after the election, because you had the Trump Tower meeting, you had Michael Flynn lying about contacts with the Russian ambassador during the transition.
And, and the interesting part of this is you know from the intelligence side that the Russians wanted to make contact with the with the campaign. And so you have that piece of hanging out there that I think we haven't seen yet. And that part of that investigation is not public yet. I imagine that that's going to be really interesting to see how successful they were. Remember, just because the Russians wanted to do it doesn't mean the campaign wanted to do it. But we know that they made that effort. And now you know that Manafort certainly had these connections, not only before the campaign, during the campaign, and now after the campaign.
Yeah.
You know, the story is certainly getting muddy.
It's really the roots of it are in counterintelligence. That's
there you go. Gentlemen, thank you. Nice to have you both. Yeah.